It's the 2K Sports pregame show, sponsored by Kia.
Welcome to the NBA on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson here with my colleagues, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Tonight, we'll see the Los Angeles Lakers playing against the Oklahoma City Thunder. Checking out Oklahoma City, they dropped the first matchup against this squad. They'll try to even the series in tonight's game. And obviously this season, quite a change for the Lakers with Kobe Bryant having retired after 20 seasons. Shaq, you played with Kobe for so long. Any memories of his time with the Lakers you'd like to share with our audience?
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank Kobe for turning me into Shaq Stradamus. What I mean by that is early in Kobe in my career, playoff game versus Utah, Kobe was the only guy who had guts to take the shot. As you can recall, I think you guys called the game. He shot three air balls in a row. He was down. And I saw he was down, and he was still the youngster on the team. I put my arm around his shoulder and said, you know what? One day you're going to be the deadliest game finisher in the universe. And it came to fruition. You know, guys saved my butt many times. So, Kobe, thank you for three in a row. Thank you for helping me get that stature. Love you, buddy.
Wow. Love is
that was right from the heart, wasn't it, Kenny?
I need a napkin.
I was going to take a tissue. Napkin's a little rough.
No, man, not for these. It's multiple tears coming down. But I just remember when he had 81 points like against the Raptors. I've watched that game on multiple times on television on playback just to see. And you know what the crazy part about it? He had a terrible first half. He just had an average first half. I wouldn't say terrible, average. And then he exploded in the second half. So I always thought, what if he had two halves like the second? He might have had 100.
And you know what? I see your point. I don't want a tissue. I don't even want a napkin. I'd like a paper towel right now. Or then maybe move up to a piece of sandpaper.
Well, Ernie, you're too elegant. No, you're too elegant. How about a handkerchief?
Handkerchief. Oh, that's a good idea.
I can't spell it, but I know how to say it.
I know how to use it.
Mm.
Hey, Kevin.
Excuse me. Sorry, guys.
Everyone is in their seats here at the Staples Center in downtown Los Angeles as the Los Angeles Lakers look to grab a win on the home floor. With Brett Berry and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan, and David Aldridge will be joining us on the sideline as well.
This road trip for the Thunder kicking things off here in this one. And, of course, Tyler Ennis.
This phase, really the integration phase, as he's getting into the new flow with his new team. An exciting time for him, for sure.
You know, the trade you were talking about, it's not front page news, but I really believe that it could pay huge dividends for this team in the future.
Brent, just how important is chemistry, and how long can it take a team to develop the good kind of chemistry?
Well, one of the important parts about chemistry that we don't talk about enough, Kevin, in my opinion, is not when things are going good. Chemistry sometimes shows itself for teams when you're at the lowest points of the season and how quickly you can dig out. So you're always developing it, but it might be most important when you're struggling.
You were reading my mind. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. So for Oklahoma City right now, Westbrook and Oladipo, the athletic backcourt duo. Taj Gibson is out there with Andre Robertson. And it's Adams in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And so the Los Angeles Lakers get the first points of the ballgame. Young in the corner. No good there. And Oklahoma City will go with it the other way. Defeated by the Pacers in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And in part because I just thought they came out flat in that game and could never recover. Just not their best effort.
You could see the coach trying a few different rotations in that game, shaking things up, trying to get something going, but nothing was working.
Tipped away and out of bounds as the Thunder gain possession.
Yeah, pretty much unforced there on the bad pass. He has to just make better decisions on the delivery when he's getting it to his teammates.
Thunder have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. And now we'll go to David Aldridge, who had a chance to talk with Coach Billy Donovan.
Well, Kevin, I talked to him about the shot blockers they face in this matchup. He said if we can play a little more up-tempo and score before their bigs can recover and get set, that'll help. Also, putting them on the move in half-court sets, whether ball screens or screen and roll, can help as well. We'll see if his team executes his game plan, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Taking on a defense like the one they're facing today has certainly got their attention.
You know, you have to watch film on them for a few minutes to see how sturdy they are defensively.
Well, the one thing you cannot do against a defense like that is relax or back down. You've got to be aggressive. You've got to stay in attack mode and make sure that they feel you.
And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Russell. And about 2 minutes played here in the first quarter. Six to shoot.
Yeah, it's one of those quarters where you're just incredibly frustrated that you did not impact it the way you wanted to. So nothing going right now.
Black the pass to Randall. Young in the corner. There's a screen. Pass to Ingram from the arc. Drops in the tray.
Not much else the D can do besides get a hand up. I mean, Ingram is just one of those guys who makes contested shots consistent.
Now here's Gibson. He's coming off a 13-point game against Indiana. Looking to end the drought. Adams dishes to Gibson. In the corner, it's Westbrook. Westbrook missing again.
And he's clearly just disappeared here this quarter, not making any contributions here with his offense.
Feels like he's compounding mistakes, too, because every miss makes him want to force something else. Not the best idea.
Now Russell, after Westbrook's missed three, Westbrook with the steal. To the middle, Adams. And Adams with the slam.
Yeah, and coming into the league, Adams would sometimes be a little bit soft around the rim. No more.
Russell with it. Now defended by Oladipo. Young against Westbrook. And Young kicks to Black. Gibson with the steal. Left side, Westbrook. They get it back. Here's Oladipo. Adams' shot is off.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Offensive rebound. Young passes to Black. Picked by Randall. Young dishes to Russell. And it's off the back rim. No good. Thunder trailing by five. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
Westbrook missing again.
Yeah, a bit frigid to begin this one. Just can't make anything to get the game started.
And the Thunder from 2011 to 2014 made the Western Conference Finals twice, as well as the NBA Finals, while still one of the youngest teams in the league. They had, Greg, all the makings of a dynasty.
You felt like they were destined to win a championship and maybe multiple ones. Now you're not so sure. It's a tough business, and being very good often isn't good enough.
Free throw good, Russell.
And D'Angelo Russell, you know, he had a tough time adapting to the pro game at first. I mean, you could see the talent from the moment he stepped on the court, but you could also see the turnovers and the lack of sustained hustle. I mean, I think a lot of it had to do, it's the first time in his career where he wasn't always the best player on the floor. And when you deal with that kind of adversity, it takes some time for you to adjust and grow as a player.
I don't even know why he's attempting some of those shots. It's just not smart basketball. And he needs to be more patient and let the offense come to him naturally.
And so it's Oklahoma City with it. After D'Angelo Russell's miss, Ingram with the steal. And oh, here we go. Young's got it. The fast break chance. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Two shots. Foul. Two.
And thinking back to Russell's rookie season, maybe too much was expected of a guy coming in at just 19 years of age.
Yeah, and we live in this win now, instant gratification era. And with the skill set and moxie this kid has, fans are going to expect the work. Just looking at what Russell did in the Rising Stars Challenge last year, though, he may ultimately fulfill all those lofty expectations.
Mm-hmm. He doesn't get the second one. And after his rookie year, it ended with an injury right out of the opening gate. It was great to finally see Julius Randle on the court last season.
Yeah, and when he's focused, guys, he can be a game changer. I mean, loves to attack off the dribble from the elbows. Terrific spin move in traffic. And what may be most impressive about his game at this point is his relentlessness as a rebounder.
Lakers leading by three. Russell kicks to Ingram.
Kick it out, kick it out.
Dishes it to Black.
Hey, heads up.
Russell passes to Ingram. Well, you look at Brandon Ingram, and certainly a great body for the game of basketball. But, guys, it's his skill that really completes the package, wouldn't you say?
Oh, no doubt about it. Shot over 40% from three-point range at Duke. He can handle and pass like a guard. One concern, though, he did shoot under 70% from the free throw line, and great shooters usually do better than that.
And Brandon Ingram, a five-star recruit out of Kinston High School, he helped them win four straight North Carolina championships, the first time that had happened in the state's history.
And that one misses.
And guys, really no ceiling on Ingram. This is a guy who has the potential to be a truly great player before it's all done.
No good at the stripe this time. Second misses also. Thunder trailing by three. Here's Roberson. No good. That would have tied it. And Ingram mentored and coached by former NBA great Jerry Stackhouse.
And I wonder if Stack was a little disappointed that Ingram didn't end up becoming a Tar Heel. Instead, choosing the arch rival and going to Duke. A one and done there. It certainly has worked out pretty well for the young fella.
Well, he's got hops, Kevin. A 42-inch vertical at the 2013 Combine. Definitely a high riser.
There's a screen. Pass to Randle. Three-pointer. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Randle's got seven.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Thunder. Now, you played all the backcourt positions, including shooting guard. Some have said the talent level at the two guard has fallen off a bit of late. Would you agree with that?
I think it's been an interesting shift, Kevin, in the NBA with regards to the scoring point guard and how much there are guards in our league who initiate offense not with the pass, but more with their ability to get to the rim, eventually get to the foul line, their ability to score the basketball and run pick and roll offenses. And with how quick teams are playing, there maybe are fewer opportunities for shooting guards to get the ball in positions where they can score.
But two guards have got to handle the ball. We're seeing that more and more, that versatility is important for teams.
No question about it. A lot of coaches are looking for complementary two guards or small forwards out there that can get to the right spots and then make the next play. After your point guard draws defense, can the next man on your team be just as effective with his pass, with his scoring? Then you got a combination that can do some damage.
Thunder trailing by four. Westbrook kicks to Gibson.
Get through, get through.
The feed to Oladipo. Count the basket.
I like seeing Oladipo around the rim using the lift inside.
L.A. has gone 2 of 2 from three-point range here in the first quarter. Russell dishes to Ingram. Here's Black. Adams defending. Over in the corner, Randle. Nice ball movement here by the Lakers. Six on the shot clock. Oklahoma City has gone a meager 1-6 from three-point land since we got started tonight. Here's Oladipo. Almost, but it rolls out.
Yeah, credit the D there. Got his hands up and made sure he wasn't comfortable on the release.
Now, sometimes coaches just tell you about changing shots rather than blocking shots. Something like that won't show up in the stat sheet, but just as important, trust me, coaches know.
Now here's Westbrook. Brandon Ingram missing his last shot. And he misses the go-ahead basket.
And the stroke definitely lacking confidence this quarter. Nothing on target.
Young against Oladipo. To the wing on the left. And Adams kicks to Oladipo. Got a piece of it. Young with the steal. And it's Brandon Ingram with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, way to get there first and be willing to absorb the contact.
A platoon swap here for the Lakers. Abrines, he's covered by Clarkson. Passes to McDermott. They set the pick. Feeds to Cole. Out left to the wing. Here's Kanter. And the shot falls short this time.
That was a half-hearted pick. And he was just going through the motions on that possession, and now it ends up costing him.
Ennis passes to Clarkson. High post shot. And Kanter pulls it down.
Well, the D wasn't awful, but it wasn't stifling either. He really should have made that shot.
That doesn't go on the chance to tie.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
And here's Clarkson. He averages more than 12 points a game. That's some dependable production. Nance trying to get back on track. He's off on that one. Now Oklahoma City takes it the other way. Their last encounter was in Oklahoma City.
Yeah, and looking back at their last game against this club, they were badly out-rebounded.
Here's Cole. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Kanter dishes to Cole, just 5 on the clock. The shot's good from Kanter.
And there's the body control of Kanter, able to adjust and convert under pressure.
LA's gone 2 of 2 from three-point range here in the first quarter. Ennis kicks to Dang, picked by Mozgov. Dang passes to Mozgov. He feeds it to Ennis. Puts up a 3. 1 up, 1 down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
Oh, a good open look, and he sprays it home from 3.
Abrines, he's covered by Clarkson. The shot's good from Kanter.
A reliable finisher who can score in a multitude of ways. Kanter is a tough cover down low.
Now here's Ennis. He's guarded closer. And Dang, here we go. The shot comes out. Excellent D from Kanter. Oklahoma City trailing. Down low. It's tipped. And that'll be Oklahoma City as it goes out of bounds. Thunder retain possession.
Risky pass in a situation like that. Very lucky that wasn't a steal.
Well, good hand-eye coordination, but he could only get the deflection very close.
Here's Kanter. 11 points for him in that last game against Indiana. There's Sabonis. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. Last game for the Lakers, it was a loss to the Bulls.
And despite the outcome, I think they'll feel a little better about that game. There are a lot of positives that they can take away from that performance.
No doubt some bright spots, more than you'd expect out of a loss like that, but it doesn't make the result any easier to take.
So it's the Thunder now, after the basket by the Lakers. Here's Cole. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Here's Kanter. Mozgov grabs the board. Mozgov's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. And out of bounds as the Thunder gain possession. Sabonis, the pass to Cole. Shoots from the line. And the shot is good, dropping in off the front of the rim.
There's 53 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Picked by Mozgov. Clarkson kicks to Mozgov. And Cancer pulls it down. They can go 2-for-1.
It's about being smart right now.
Ennis dishes to Mozgov. That one doesn't go. And the Thunder going the other way now. McDermott passes to Cantor. So they take the lead. Cantor's got his third bucket of the night.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Now, here's Clarkson. His last outing, he had 8 points. Picked by Mozgov. Here's Dang. No good on the buzzer beater. And a closely contested grit and grind first quarter comes to a close. Thunder lead by one. Live from the Staples Center, you're watching 2K Sports. And a moment now to hear from Steven Adams as he reflects back in a life growing up as the youngest of 18 children back in New Zealand.
So, like, the youngest over there has to do everything, like, all chores, pretty much 18 years of being rookie. That's pretty much all it is, and people just beat you up for no reason.
Hard to imagine growing up in such a huge family, but it sounds like maybe it prepared him for life in the NBA.
Yeah, I'd say it might have toughened him up a little bit, that's for sure. Wow, 18? That is mind-boggling.
And off we go, a close game now starting the second quarter. And when you consider how the Thunder are doing, guys, what do you think?
You know, they're not going to sit back and just take jump shots. It's all about attacking the paint and getting to the rim.
Well, those high percentage shots have keyed their offense tonight, and until the defense packs the lane, no reason to shift their strategy.
Taking a look at the Thunder, Sabonis and Cantor, the pair inside. Then it's Norris Cole, then it's McDermott.
And the thing about Laker fans, I mean, they've always been used to their team being the favorite to win most nights. Lately, though, it's more about the excitement that their young players bring to the game and hopefully the bright future ahead.
Now here's Mozgov. Pulled the shot a little left, but the bounce goes his way. Mozgov's got 4 points this quarter.
I'm open.
Cole, the pass to Sabonis. McDermott, and finished off by McDermott.
And guys, this game won't be close for long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G.A. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
Well, we talked about the D. Let's credit the offense. He attacked right there from the moment he saw the opening, not letting the defense react.
Now let's go to the sideline and catch up with our Hall of Famer, David Aldridge.
Okay, we know that the Thunder hired Billy Donovan as its new head coach. In his 2 decades at the University of Florida, he led them to 2 national titles with players like Al Horford and Joakim Noah. A defensive-minded coach, he's developed into a great offensive mind. Fellas, that's what he's trying to bring to OKC, moving the floor, as he calls it, creating space for their great scorers to operate.
Ball movement, player movement, that's where the league is going, D.A., thanks. And thinking about the element of excitement that the Lakers bring, it's about watching their tremendous athletes who also happen to have a lot of skill, too.
It's a different kind of showtime for the Lakers. I mean, it's the joy of watching the young guys grow up and the pain of seeing them make mistakes. One thing we can say about Tinseltown, though, it's never boring.
No. Lakers shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
Free throw good, Clarkson.
And what a solid producer Jordan Clarkson was over those first 2 seasons quickly adapted to the NBA style. He was named NBA All-First Team in terms of rookies. And last year, he became a much more confident shooter. I mean, despite having to fight for those minutes as they went on that serenading of Kobe Bryant, he really, I felt like, separated himself and also established that he's going to be here for the long haul.
And talking about Clarkson's early success, some people were surprised, Greg, that he lasted until the second round of the 2014 draft. Maybe that put a bit of a chip on his shoulder.
I'm shocked he didn't go in the first round. I mean, he certainly plays with a strength and a fearlessness, especially when attacking the rim. I think he does want to prove that he should be considered one of the best young guards in our league. He's certainly one of the best young mid-range shooters at the very least.
Nance, no good.
Shocking he blew that opportunity, guys. 9 times out of 10, that is an easy make.
Westbrook kicks to Oladipo. Six on the shot clock. Kicks it to Adams. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Now just a 1-point Laker lead.
Well, great efficiency on the inside from Steven Adams. Rarely does he take a bad shot.
They set the pick. Nance dishes to Clarkson. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. Clarkson's got 4 points in the quarter.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Fearless, despite the size mismatch, took it right to him.
Now here's Westbrook. 32 points for him last game against Indiana.
And he also was really tenacious about attacking the D and creating wide open shots for his other guys. That's why his teammates love him.
No good from Gibson.
And listen, sometimes even the best of us are going to miss the easiest of opportunities.
And Mozgov throws it down.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants
to. Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one. Here's Adams. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Now Ennis. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. When you look around, we see a lot more face-up power forwards than in decades past. That's what teams
shots,
are
gentlemen.
Looking for, wouldn't you say?
I'd say teams are looking for, Kevin, guys who at the 4 and 5 spot can help a team move the ball from strong side to weak side, be able to read some defenses, make proper passes, and then set screens and be a presence on the roll. That's absolutely at the 4 and 5 spot what teams are trying to find today.
But do you think players now, Brent, are smarter than they were coming in?
I don't know how to check the report cards, Kevin. No, the players, because of their versatility, and I think growing up not playing back to the basket and being asked to do a lot more things that require guard skills when they come into the game and coaches are asking them to do these things, they're more than capable of doing them.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Tarik Black, he's checked in for Mozgov. Randle comes in for Nance. Nick Young's checked in for Jordan Clarkson. And it's Russell in for Tyler Ennis. He hits the second from the line. Thunder trailing by 6.
I'm open.
Westbrook with it. 5 points in the game. The offensive rebound. And he comes up with the deuce. Gibson's got his first 2 points of the night.
Now he snakes around that offensive glass, played that carom just right.
Los Angeles has gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Ingram setting a pick for Russell to the inside and slam dunk by Ingram.
And at 6'9", Ingram is constantly on the prowl for these dunks. An incredible athlete who just finishes with ease near the hoop.
Now here's Westbrook. He averages over 27 points a game and seems to always find a way to score. The pass to Adams. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got 3 assists in the game. And here's Russell. He's coming off a 13-point game against Chicago. And now a fast break for the Thunder. And Gibson kicks to Oladipo.
Well, if you ask around the league about the moves that the Thunder made with the trade for Victor Oladipo at the 2016 draft, most people would tell you they got the better of it. Oladipo, the best shooting guard they've had since James Harden.
And the first one drops.
2013, Victor Oladipo heard his name second in that draft. One of the best shooting guards in the league and getting better.
Oladipo hits them both. The Lakers in the lead. Here's Russell. And you can see his scoring totals. Those are some pretty good numbers. He's putting up close to 15 points a game on average. Here's Roberson. That misses off the backboard.
And you know what? That's one of those heat checks if he's taking shots like that.
And even though he's been on a roll tonight, that one was a bit forced.
And you know, Brent, the Oklahoma City Thunder for so long making do with one way at the off-guard position.
I think you're right, Kevin, and maybe Victor Oladipo changes that. Over 15 points per game for his career, and a very aggressive and athletic defender, a legit two-way player for OKC.
First one falls for him.
The team just cannot get into a groove from the free throw line. It's a common problem for them.
He hits one and misses one, each at the line. And when having discussions about the Lakers over the years, one word that has rarely been mentioned is rebuild. The franchise is used to championships, not rebuilding.
And another word that they lack is superstar. Mm-hmm. You're not accustomed to seeing the Lakers without a true superstar on that roster. And they've also always been a top destination for the A-list free agents.
The shot off that time. Russell passes to Ingram. Great D that time from Gibson. Thunder trailing by three. Now here's Westbrook. 5 points in the game. Right side Gibson. And that one off the back of the rim and in. Gibson's got his second basket of the game.
And that's just not something Russell came in doing, being a playmaker. But what we're seeing out of Westbrook now, great vision. And the Thunder, one of the best shooting teams in the league. And if they don't get you with that first shot, they have guys inside prepared for those misses to hurt you the second time around.
A chance here to assess what parts of the floor the attempts have been coming from as we look at the shot chart for the Thunder.
And you see not a lot of corner threes. The defense doing a good job of closing out and denying those shorter distance triples. That's what the smart teams have to do.
Lakers have gone 6 of 9 in the second quarter. Some good work from the field. And you look at the Thunder's work on second effort plays. Brent, a lot of big bodies in their front court who don't mind throwing their weight around.
Well, Russell Westbrook himself is a phenomenal rebounding guard, but I think what happens, too, is that players on OKC set themselves up in great position to clean up any misses.
Thunder trailing by three. Gibson the screen. Gibson setting the pick for Westbrook. A wide-open look here for Oladipo. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook.
Slowly and steadily improving, Oladipo, a good three-point shooter, making him more well-rounded as a threat.
Russell dishes to Black. Ingram kicks to Young. Tries a three. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City. Roberson's got three rebounds now in this one.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical.
Here's Russell after the made shot from Victor Oladipo. Outside, Russell. It's deflected. It's stolen by Adams. And now it's Westbrook running. He can go all the way. Finish off the break. Westbrook's got 4 points in the quarter.
And playing with a lot of fire now. They had a tough start in that first quarter. Didn't shoot it well, but didn't let that discourage them. And now they're showing what they can do offensively.
No one near Randle as he lets it go. Sinks the triple. Randle's got 10 points.
Yes, he's too exceptional from deep range to leave uncovered.
They get the rebound. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
Well, love the aggressive play here from Adams. He gets the shot he wants, and now another opportunity to challenge himself at the free throw line.
And watching Adams go to work out there, he is a bit of an old school big man in the sense that Brent Hill, he'll throw his weight around and look to intimidate the other team.
Yeah, Adams willing to take on that role, take the punches and take the hits for the rest of his team. And it goes along with his great defensive instincts, I think. His activity down low, certainly a big help for this team's defense.
Los Angeles making a switch here. Deng's checked in, and a new group in here for the Thunder. Sabonis, he's checked in for Gibson. Doug McDermott comes in for Andre Robertson. Abrines has checked in for Oladipo. And Cole's subbed in for Russell Westbrook. Now, here is Russell. It's tipped. And pushing it up here. Here is Oklahoma City. Cole's got the ball. And another shot. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And while we got a chance, let's look at some numbers for Adams. 17th in field goal percentage. And, of course, rim protection always at a premium. That's an important part of his game. Top 20 in blocks per.
And this is his second trip to the line tonight.
Not the best statistic for him in terms of his performance at the line. Very low numbers.
That free throw, no good.
You always talk about glue guys and guys that do the little things to help their team. Steven Adams is certainly that for the Oklahoma City Thunder. Not a big presence in the box to score, but when you watch him play with his team, he's willing to sacrifice his body, set hard screens, and be a presence on the interior.
He's off on the second. And thinking again on Adams, the scoring isn't what makes him valuable. Granted, it's his defense and his solid screen setter.
I think it's his idea that the role that he has is something that he's very comfortable with, and he wants to be successful at doing it. He doesn't hurt the team by getting out of his comfort zone.
He was all alone on that one. Abrines has got his first 3 points of the game.
Wide open there. The defense just completely in snooze mode.
Outside, Russell. He kicks it to Black. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two. It's amazing to watch these NBA athletes competing every day. You and I get the lucky seat right there in front midcourt, such size, such athleticism. It's intimidating. Who are the most intimidating players, you think, in the game today?
If you go to Detroit and you want to match up with number zero there, and Andre Drummond,
look out.
You're in for a long night.
Harness yourself in.
The way that he can patrol the middle, Kevin, and the way he's relentless at coming at the offensive glass and the defensive glass all game long, I'm really interested in the development of Andre Drummond as the centerpiece, figuratively and literally, for the Detroit Pistons.
Enes Kanter's checked in for Steven Adams. And so he makes both from the line. The Thunder leading by three. Here's Cole. The layup missed.
You can see he just rushed that a little bit. Lost the focus, I think.
Russell passes to Deng. Shot clock at 6. Inside. Got a piece of it. Stolen by Kanter. McDermott kicks to Kanter. Sabonis with the bucket. Sabonis has got the lead up to 5 now for the Thunder.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Here's the screen. Nick Young on the wing. From 17 feet out, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Nick Young. That's foul number 2 for him.
And that's foul number 2. And maybe you don't sit him at this point, but you really have to be careful to not pick up another before half.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tarik Black. Nance comes in for Randall. And it's Clarkson in for Nick Young. Cantor's shot is off.
Yeah, it's tough. His shot's been off today. Luckily, his team still has the edge in the game so far.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, guys, it seems at times that Russell Westbrook can put up a triple-double at will. But he said, everybody thinks that I care about numbers and things like that, but I really don't. I don't think about who shoots, how many times they shoot. That really doesn't matter to me. I just like to win. All that matters is if we win. Kevin?
XD8, one of the most competitive players in the NBA. Here's Cole after the basket by Timofey Mozgov. Some nice passing by Oklahoma City here. And it's blocked. And he recovers it. And it's good for 2. Cole's got his second basket of the night.
Yeah, after a first quarter where they struggled from long range, they've really started to get it closer to the basket.
Picked by Mozgov. A drive by Russell. And Mozgov throws it down.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. Cole, the pass to Sabonis. Cole's shot is good. Cole's got 4 points now in the quarter.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda. Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Gentlemen, 2 shots. Loose shots.
And he makes the first. And so Russell hits them both. There's 21 seconds left in the first half of basketball. Here's Cole. 6 points for him. He dishes it to Kanter. Shoots from 14. The offensive rebound. Sabonis. And released it in time, but it's off the mark. And the first half comes to a close. We've got a close game going on here. Thunder out in front. They lead by 3. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Russell, how confident are you that there's nobody that can stay in front of you?
Very confident. I have a lot of confidence in myself. I put a lot of work in the summertime, but I'm very confident.
That is never a problem for you, Russ. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you, and stay with us, folks. We'll be back just after halftime to get the third quarter started.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, folks, welcome back. Ernie Johnson alongside Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. A lot of action so far in this one. A competitive matchup for Oklahoma City in the first quarter. They were able to squeeze ahead by the end of the period with just a 1-point lead. If you look at the second quarter scoring, they had a small edge. They really hung tough as we got close to halftime. Kenny, let's get your take on Oklahoma City.
Well, I see a team that's playing smart, moving the ball around to the open man, just taking what the defense gives them. There's a nice flow, a nice energy, a nice synergy to the game.
Shaq, what was your takeaway on the Lakers?
They were undisciplined, turning it over way too much. Poor ball handling, lazy passing. These guys have had to be counting their lucky stars that this game has not gotten away from them.
And time now to send you back down to the floor with Kevin Harlan. We will see you after the game.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Victor Oladipo really making a difference here.
And he just went off in those first two quarters, guys. He's capable of doing that on a consistent basis as well. So we might see some changes from a defensive standpoint as they try to disrupt his rhythm in the second half.
There's got to be some consideration that double teams will be sent his way. Of course, that's going to leave someone else wide open. And quite frankly, the Thunder are just one of the most dangerous offensive teams out there, but their defense is solid too. A lot of good one-on-one defenders in their rotation, near the top of the league in defensive efficiency.
Ingram and Randall, the young forward tandem. D'Angelo Russell out there with Young. And it's Black in at the five spot. And that's the group for Luke Walton as we begin the second half. Now, here is Young. Brandon Ingram missing his last shot. Here's Randall, and Randall throws it down.
An aggressive move and fantastic finish.
Trying to send a message with that slam, I think. The Thunder with the lead. And the Thunder did a good job of challenging shooters and locking down on D. They also know how, as we've seen, to protect the rim.
Well, a lot of that success last year on the interior has to be given to Steven Adams and the incredible progression that he showed as a center in this league. Really figuring out what it is that his opponents like to do and how he can be effective.
Inside, here's Westbrook. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. That's on D'Angelo Russell.
Yeah, he just has physical tools to make you go in there and foul him. Westbrook back to the line.
And Kevin, what's remarkable to me about Westbrook is that as much as he is used in the offensive game plan, I mean, this is a guy that is the focal point in terms of how they're going to play. That's a tremendous amount of pressure on a player, no matter how talented he is.
And both free throws good for Westbrook. And thinking again about Westbrook and his high usage rate, it's incredible, Greg, because he still plays entirely efficient.
It's crazy. I mean, normally the more shots you take, the more your efficiency drops. But Westbrook seems to be free of that. It's a big reason why this team lets Westbrook do so much for them on the offensive end.
On the clock. And Young, here we go. Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist. Russell's got 5 assists tonight.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Now here's Westbrook. 9 points in the game so far.
Watch outside!
The dish to Gibson. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
Oh, going high to throw that one down.
Sky high. Fantastic one-hand jam. Russell dishes to Young. Here's Black, and looking at his production, he averages a little more than 7 points a game. And he'll shoot free throws here, clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistle blowing.
So perfect to see Russell Westbrook playing for the Thunder because he himself is a force of nature. A couple of seasons ago, he had 3 knee surgeries in less than 1 year. And everyone was worried he might lose some of that explosiveness. Are you sure that's not a bionic knee he's got in there?
The first one falls. And you know, Westbrook, Brent, undaunted by the knee surgeries, and up until that collision with Patrick Beverley, he had never missed a game. High school, college at UCLA, never.
No, he never missed one of your broadcasts either, Kevin. You remember in 2015, he got kneed in the face and had to have surgery to repair that cheekbone. So he wore that mask in his return, and then he reeled off that amazing string of triple-doubles. I'm not sure he's human. Can we check his blood type?
Here's the break. Here's Oladipo, and finished off by Oladipo.
Oladipo showing you just a bit of everything tonight, aggressive in his attack.
Outside, Russell. to the paint. Here's Ingram. It's good, and he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play chance here. Tyler Ennis, who's checked in for Los Angeles. And that one falls for Ingram. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Oladipo against Young. Oladipo outside. Here's Westbrook again, Oklahoma City.
Well, able to explode in the paint at will, and a great finisher. Westbrook a terror once he gets in there.
Ennis kicks to Ingram. Pass to Randle. To the left wing. Picked by Randle. Ennis passes to Ingram. The Lakers need to get a shot off here. And they force the shot clock violation. Great D. And a look here at the shot chart.
And every time he's pulled up from deep and let it fly, it's found a way to catch iron. Not sure if it is something with his release or the defense is bothering him on his threes, but I would expect him to attack the rim a bit just to kind of mix things up.
Oklahoma City leading by three. In the corner, Gibson with it. Oklahoma City moving the ball around. Westbrook dishes to Oladipo. Back to Westbrook. Gibson the screen. There's the triple. Another miss by Westbrook.
Well, he made one three in the first half, but he hasn't found a way to connect again from outside during the second.
Ennis kicks to Randle, and that one goes out of bounds. Nice touch by Oladipo.
And let's take a look at some numbers for Russell Westbrook. First in scoring, and he's in the top five in the league in steals. Those hands are like meat hooks. Not much gets by him.
It's stolen by Adams. Now Oladipo. He's got 13. And they call over the back here. Too much contact.
Yeah, he was boxed out and tried to get the rebound the only way he could.
Roberson the pass to Westbrook. Gibson dishes to Oladipo. Pass to Westbrook. Shot, high post. The putback, it's good on the putback. Adams has got the lead up to five now for Oklahoma City.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Now here's Ingram. 11 points in the game. And the Lakers with another miss. And Roberson kicks to Oladipo. Shoots from 14. Misses off the right iron.
The shots like that drive coaches batty. I'll be shocked if he attempts that shot again. You know, looking at his release and his form, it just seems like something is off, and it's affecting both his shot and, at this point, his confidence.
Westbrook with the bucket.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Now here's Ennis. He's covered by Westbrook.
And what an alley-oop. Those two read each other so well.
It's a play I'm sure they love to run. The Thunder leading by five.
You see Billy Donovan out there on the sidelines, and you can't help but to think of all the success he's had as a coach already. Back-to-back titles in college. Essentially built that Florida basketball program into a powerhouse. He's hoping that he can bring some of that success translated to the NBA and get himself in title contending position.
Here's Ennis. The Thunder making the shot. Floats it up for Young. And Young with the stuff.
And hard to decide which was better, the pass, the catch, or the slam.
Well, there's no wrong answer. Sensational alley-oop. Oladipo with the ball. He's got 13. And the shot is good. And the Thunder lead by seven.
And that's what we mean by combo guard skills right there. Kept his head up and found the open man.
Ennis kicks to Young. Ennis in the corner. Back the pass to Ingram. Hits the layup after the sweet pump fake to freeze the D. Ingram's got 6 points in the quarter.
And you gotta love the big bucket in the paint in this sort of a grind-it-out game.
And Oladipo kicks to Westbrook. The 17-footer. Moves back up. He scores a sixth bucket from the floor with that one. He's shot the ball 11 times.
Another rebound hauled in. They're hitting the glass with a lot of passion.
Los Angeles calls timeout. You know, Brent, when you take a look at the fit for Oklahoma City with Russell Westbrook and Victor Oladipo, that might be the most athletic backcourt tandem in the NBA.
Well, you'd be hard-pressed in the Western Conference to find a backcourt that has this kind of athleticism. McCollum and Lillard in Portland, that's one way to go. Steph and Clay in Golden State, that's another. But sheer athleticism right here in OKC, they may be tops.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Mozgov, he's checked in for Tarik Black. Nance comes in for Julius Randle. Luol Deng is checked in for Ingram. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Young. Oklahoma City leading by 7. Abrines the pass to Sabonis. And that'll be Oklahoma City as it goes out of bounds. Thunder retain possession. On defense, the Lakers. From outside the arc, Cole's shot is good. Cole's got 9.
Yes, he's too exceptional from deep range to leave uncovered.
For Los Angeles, they've gone a solid 6 of 11 when shooting here in the third quarter. Hit by Mozgov. Clarkson and dishes to Mozgov. Here's Nance. Tries from the block. And while we can now, let's check in on the top scoring rookies in the NBA. You take a look at Sabonis, top 5 scorer in the league. What a player he is.
Well, coming in, you wondered how his talent would translate at this level in terms of scoring. And I've got to say, apparently, it's translating pretty well.
And the first one drops. We've heard a lot of talk around the league about the strain of the regular season. Brent, 82 games, putting a strain with the back-to-backs of 4 games and 5 nights.
I'm getting tired of you just talking about it, Kevin.
I'm tired of saying it.
I'm exhausted.
So what's the solution?
I really think that the preseason only needs to be 4 games. You could also do something, Kevin, with regards to training camp where you'd have players in their first through 4 seasons come in for 10 days prior to the veterans coming into camp, the 4 preseason games, and then you're ready to go. So the NBA now, with their 22 affiliations with NBA D-League teams, have the opportunity for those guys to get in shape and learn the system going in between the big ball club and the D-League. But I think a shorter preseason schedule is on the horizon.
Excellent thoughts. Here we are in November. Let's see how things are shaking out in the West early in the season. Take a look at the Lakers. Here in the early part of the season, they've acquired the 3rd best record in the conference. And, of course, Oklahoma City, 3 games behind.
And, you know, for the Thunder, so far it looks like the adjustments they made in the offseason aren't going to produce the desired effect.
Yeah, lots of season left to go, so maybe a little too early to say that. The results have been anything but positive early on, but we've seen plenty of teams dig themselves out of big holes after early season woes.
That's good from Cantor. And just thinking about the way Cantor's career has gone, a lot of high expectations early, Brent, and a starting job after he moved teams.
And I think that might be a key for Cantor in the role of being a scoring big man off the bench. Really can play to his strength, and he can take advantage of another team's second unit, maybe not ready or equipped to handle what he brings to the table offensively. Well, what you have to like about Enes Kanter, defense aside, is that he's an efficient scorer. He's got great instincts to offensive rebound and be in position for somebody to feed him the ball on the inside.
Dishes it to Cole. Passes it to Abrines. And the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Abrines has got his second bucket of the night. And for Kanter, his play is what everyone envisioned for him when he was taken third overall back in that 2011 draft.
Well, the hopes for every general manager looking at Kanter was that he'd be a great low post scorer, and that's where he's shown most of his prowess, there and at the offensive glass, where he just simply swallows everything up and puts it back in the basket.
And so it's Oklahoma City with it, following the three by the Lakers.
Well, he's not a polished post player by any means, but he must finish those looks in tight.
Here's Deng. It's good, the assist that time from Enes. Enes has got four assists in the game. Oklahoma City leading by seven. And Cole kicks to Kanter. There's the pick. And there's the pass to Abrines. Lock at six. Mozgov with the block. And here's Clarkson. 9 points in the game so far. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
And one of the problems in the first half, that shoddy work at the free throw line. They needed to fix that, and they've been much improved since the break.
And the first one drops. And the Lakers making a change here. Russell's checked in. Off on that one, so he goes 1 for 2 at the line. Here's Cole. He's got 9. Oklahoma City moving it around. And there's the feed to McDermott. Off target from 3-point range.
Perfect positioning, and you know he will knock that look down more times than not. Just didn't connect there.
Nance, and Nance shoots it in.
And you can sense things now starting to tighten up. Their offense has become unstoppable.
Right, big scoring run fueled by great game planning and really some great shot making.
And here now the Thunder after the basket by the Lakers. There's a good screen. Sabonis, the pass to Abrines. A floater, unable to get that one. Excellent D there from Mozgov. Coach is liking what he's seeing from his offense.
And guys, they put the defense on the defensive. And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Here's Cole. To the inside. Kanter's shot is off. Here's the Lakers with the ball. They're on a 12-4 run. Russell dishes to Nance. Back to Russell. And it's all evened up. Russell's got 7.
This team really feeds off of one another in terms of their energy.
At least in the second half they have been. The first half wasn't played anywhere near this intense.
Here's Cole. He's got 9. Feeds it to Kanter. Leans inside. And it's Kanter again missing.
Well, that's a shot right there he's going to hit 9 times out of 10. We just saw the 10% he doesn't make.
Stolen by Kanter. And the Thunder pushing it up now. Here's McDermott. Makes it off the glass. McDermott's got his second bucket tonight.
And the defense to start that play was terrific. I love the fact that they attacked early in the shot clock.
Here's Russell. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. And this is his 4th trip to the free throw line tonight.
And he has grooved his stroke at the line this season and been able to maintain it with an average of 90%.
And he can't get the first one. Good on the second free throw. Oklahoma City's gone 1-of-4 in three-point shots here in the third. 32 seconds left in the third. Cole, the pass to Sabonis. He feeds it to Cantor. Four on the shot clock. Oklahoma City needs to get off a shot. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
Well, time and score, you just can't have a costly error right now at this point in the game, guys.
Here's the Lakers with the ball. They're on a 15-6 run. Now, here is Russell. 8 points for him. Picked by Mozgov. Throws it up high. It's still anybody's game as we've reached the end of three. Thunder lead by one. And right after this, we'll bring you the start of the final quarter right here on 2K Sports. Now let's hear what head coach Billy Donovan was reviewing with his team in the huddle.
We've done a great job moving the ball. Let's keep the ball moving. Extra pass, attack, pass, and play, okay?
Billy Donovan enjoying the activity his team is showing. The motion of his offense, just wants to see more of it.
Yeah, they're working together well. The key now is to try to do it consistently throughout the rest of this evening.
Welcome back as we get rolling once more. The fourth quarter right ahead in what's been a very well-contested game. So the Thunder 5 right now. Westbrook and Oladipo, the athletic backcourt duo. Enes Kanter is out there with Taj Gibson. And it's Roberson in at the 3.
Hey, swing it.
Oladipo against Young. Fires the 3. Oladipo misses. The Lakers trail. Young outside. Russell kicks to Black. Chance there to take the lead. Missing. The Thunder shooting a meager 37% for the game. Roberson. Second chance shot. Here's Oladipo. Out of bounds. The Lakers will take possession.
I mean, there's not a lot of reasons for a turnover, but there's certainly not one there. Just a lapse of judgment.
Julius Randle's checked in for Nance. And Oklahoma City also making a switch. Adams checked in. L.A. is gone. 5 of 8 from three-point land. 15 points and a deep ball for them tonight. Russell dishes to Ingram. Kicks to Black. Picked by Randle to take the lead. Westbrook with the nice D there.
You know, if you're going to go set a pick, you really have to be committed to it. He simply did not do a good enough job to get his teammate open.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Here's Randle following the score by Oklahoma City. Young outside. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. It's going to be on Victor Oladipo. And the first one at the line is good.
And so Young nails them both. We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. Russell against Westbrook. There's the dish to Robertson. Looking for Adams. He gets it there. With the second effort, the shot misses. Nice D from Russell. Lakers shooting 49% on the game. They'll take that. Here's Randle. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead. And they now lead as the free throw drops for him. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Oladipo against Young. Gibson passes to Adams. Near the three-point line, it's Westbrook. Bounces high off the rim and drops.
And no hesitation with Westbrook being challenged on that shot. That's just how much confidence he has in his game.
Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Russell kicks to Young. Over in the corner, Randle. Shot clock at 6. Gibson with the steal. Launches it. Another shot. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Well, Adams with the make them pay mentality right here from the free throw line.
Good on the free throw. And the second free throw, good.
Well, I mean, a semi-productive trip to the free throw line, but we'll see whether or not it costs them.
Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. Russell with it. Now defended by Oladipo. Inside. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. And the Thunder lead by 4.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Russell kicks to Young. Over in the corner, Randle. Lakers passing it around. Here's Russell. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. The first free throw is good. He's perfect from the line this time. Look at the clock. A little under 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth. Westbrook against Russell. Westbrook kicks to Oladipo. Fires from deep. The rebound by the Lakers. Randle's got 5 rebounds tonight. Down low. Here's Black. And a dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
And that kind of defense ain't gonna get it done.
Gee, we don't see those kinds of dunks out of him all the time, but we know he's got it in him.
Well, any guy can throw it down against air defending him. Plenty of room, so not so amazing. What does amaze me, though, is that no one came over to contest the play.
Oladipo misses.
And really no excuse for him missing that one, guys. He has to knock that shot down.
Russell. Offensive rebound. Here's Randall. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. No good on that one. And no good on the second free throw, so he goes 0-for-2 there. Oklahoma City's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Here's Westbrook. Randall grabs the board. Randall's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. Russell kicks to Randall. Three-pointer. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Russell's got assist number 9 now. Wow, what an effort here tonight. Thunder trailing by 3. Outside Gibson. He kicks it to Oladipo. And Robertson has it in the corner. Looking for Gibson. He gets it there. And it's Gibson finishing it off.
Oh, going high to throw that one down.
Sky high. Fantastic one-hand jam. Now Russell. To the middle. Here's Black. Gibson with the steal. Oladipo with the ball. With the teardrop.
Well, watch Robertson play, and you'll see why it is that he's respected amongst his teammates. Great length with his arms, can guard the 1-4 position, and blends size and speed. The only thing that you'd like to see is him improve his consistency from the three-point line.
Free throw, no good.
And as many times as we've seen him at the free throw line tonight, I think by now we know what's going to happen.
And the second free throw, good.
And shaking his head moment there, had a chance to put them out in front, but at least they're tied up.
Russell against Westbrook. Fades. And all around the rim that time before dropping in. 12 points for D'Angelo Russell. Thinking a bit more about Robertson and his defense. He can do it all from jumping a passing lane to sending a shot into the third row.
Yeah, so really for him, it's all about timing. Very smart in the way he lines up to block shots and a good sense of knowing when to jump in and help off the ball.
The Lakers have gone 3-of-6 in the field so far in the fourth quarter. Not watching the line there, that'll be a backcourt violation.
Well, those 5 turnovers, more than you like to see.
Here's Oladipo, and it's Oladipo with the jam.
Well, continuing his growth as a leader on this team, Westbrook now becoming one of the sharper playmakers in the NBA.
Now here's Ingram. He dishes it to Black. It's stolen by Adams. Pass to Roberson. To take the lead. And out of bounds as the Lakers gain possession. Los Angeles has gotten 2/3 of their 3-pointers to fall tonight. They're 6-of-9 overall. And here is Ingram. to the paint, flat. And he takes the fantastic lead pass up strong for the slam.
And the passing of Ingram, setting up his teammates and distributing the ball effortless.
Young with the steal. To Randle, back to Russell, poked away. Here's Randle. Outside Russell, lock at six, throws it up high.
Oh, and just a soft touch on both ends of that pretty alley-oop.
I gotta say, when he threw the pass, I didn't know where it was going. Thunder trailing by four. Oladipo outside, screened by Adams. And again, no good by Oklahoma City.
Just not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far, just not himself in the second half.
Young for three. No good there. Nice D from Oladipo. Thunder shooting in the fourth quarter down around 31%, not playing with as much energy here lately. Here's Ingram. They're running. Pull up Jay. Here's Roberson. Good on the bucket.
Well, the anticipation for steals that Westbrook shows, I mean, maybe playing point guard paying off on the defensive end to help create that fast break.
Now, here is Russell. Inside. Here's Randle. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. That free throw good from Randle. Jordan Clarkson, he's checked in for Los Angeles. All free throws good from Randle.
And he has been battling some serious demons at the line tonight. Good to see him finally come through on that trip.
Trying to break that ice-cold streak. Count it, and the Laker lead has been cut down to just 2 points on the bucket from Westbrook.
Great recognition there from Russell Westbrook. You take away his path to the basket, he can still just rise up and get you from the mid-range.
Now, here is Russell. Dishes it to Randle. Now, here's Clarkson from the baseline. It's stolen by Oladipo. Fader on the way, and he didn't get quite enough under that one.
Man, he's missing those kind of good looks. His team is in some serious trouble.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And the foul goes against Oklahoma City. The first one falls. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Thunder trailing by four. Outside Westbrook. Passes it to Adams. Outside Gibson. It's Oladipo on the wing. He's covered by Clarkson, and the shot goes in.
Typically, you don't have a lot of sets that get through Steven Adams, but on the offensive end tonight, he's been aggressive.
Outside Russell.
Shot clock at 5. There's the pass to Ingram. To the inside. Gibson with the steal. Oladipo against Clarkson. A 1:50 left in the fourth quarter. Adams with the screen on Russell. 6 on the shot clock. To take the lead. That one, no good.
Might want to stop shooting from out there right now because it's just not working. He needs to look to get his teammates involved at this point in the game.
And Roberson pulls it down. Roberson's got 8 rebounds in this game. The feed to Oladipo, to the paint, to tie it up. And it's Westbrook missing.
And you know they wanted that one to go down.
Man, that's just tough because that would have tied up the score. That's a tough one to swallow here in the fourth.
Now, here is Russell. He's at the pick. Sendicious to Black. A baseline J. Westbrook with the steal. 51 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Stolen by Clarkson. Jumps up. Count it!
What a bucket at one of the more crucial moments of the game.
That is showing a very steady hand with the pressure dialed to 11.
Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City. They trail by 4. There's 45 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Billy Donovan talking to his team. He told them we've got to make the most of every chance right now. This is a winnable game, but we've got to make plays. Guys, we'll see if they can come back.
All right, thank you, David. There's 45 seconds left to play in the final quarter. And so they foul intentionally. It's the first one, and that puts them up by 5. Second one is good. And both at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Yeah, showing off a really smooth stroke there, and that will add to their lead.
Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. They're down by 6. 40 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Here's Oladipo. Feeds to Roberson. Back to Oladipo. Westbrook with it. He's picked up by Russell. Connects! And now they trail by just 4.
Steven Adams just does not need the ball to be effective out there on the floor. But when he does shoot, he's an extremely high percentage shooter.
So the first one drops, and that puts them up by 5. So he gets them both, and it's a 6-point ball game. There's 31 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Westbrook with a wide open look. That's 3-pointers off the mark, and now they decide to foul intentionally.
You have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
2-2.
He hits the first one, and that makes it a 7-point lead. So he gets them both, and it's an 8-point game. Time called here. The Thunder decide to talk it over. They're losing by 8. There's 21 seconds left in the game. Guys, your thoughts?
You know, I think he's just trying to send his team a message, you know, not willing to give up on this game just yet. Just trying to instill that fight in this group.
Well, you still can't control the outcome. Only playing your hardest moment to moment. That's what he's getting through to them now.
Here's Cole. Pass to Abrines. A 3-ball. Rebound collected by Clarkson. He feeds it to Ennis. And so Los Angeles takes the win. Some good competition, but the hometown advantage and their ability to stay focused, I think, made the difference.
Yeah, and the first step in becoming a good team is your ability to win at home. And they really seem to revel in that opportunity. And this is what they came out to do.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. And as the fans file out of the building, now time to head over to Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith for the postgame show.
The 2K Sports postgame show.
Thank you, Kevin. Now we move on to our Jordan player of the game, Brandon Ingram. You know, tonight he put up his high for the season. Found his rhythm, never let up. Just a terrific scoring effort all the way around.
Listen, he didn't let him down. He came through with a fantastic performance. That's showing some character at a critical time. This was the game they needed, Ernie. He said, give me the ball and move.
With his length and scoring ability, Brandon Ingram is deadly. Smaller defenders are helpless against him, and he's just as good off the ball as he is with the ball. An efficient performance and key to this win.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Kenny Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, for Kevin Harlan, and for the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. I hope you have a wonderful, even beyond wonderful, a spectacular, just great. I mean, see you.
Good night.